We saw Laurent Gbagbo earlier today at The Hague in the ICC. He and his supporters, as you know, say that he is the victim of a justice system that is more about politics than justice. What's your response?
I think this is very important for Cote d'Ivoire. The International Criminal Court is helping Cote d'Ivoire to identify if Mr. Gbagbo is responsible for crimes or not, to identify what happened there, establishing the law to help them to live together. That is what the International Criminal Court is doing here.
You say this is important for Cote d'Ivoire, but how credible can this legal process be if the leader of only one of the two sides accused of mass violations of human rights is being pursued legally?
Look, this court is impartial, it has nothing to do with the parties involved in the conflict, and it's changing completely history in the world. In the past, head of states were able to commit crimes and nothing happened to them. Eventually, they go to golden exile. Now, Mr. Gbagbo, a former head of state, is facing justice. That is a new time we are living. No more crimes, no more atrocities.
You are right, Mr. Moreno Ocampo. Many leaders are accused of crimes and nothing happens to them, and we've seen this in many cases. Many people would look at the cases, in fact, that you have pursued and that have been pursued by the ICC, the arrest warrants that have been issued, the investigations that have been opened, and will wonder if the court hasn't been the African Criminal Court, not the International Criminal Court.
There are many allegations against different sides. We have a duty to be impartial. We conduct investigations for all the crimes committed, and we present different cases as soon as we got the evidence. So this case against Mr. Gbagbo is the first case, not the last case. We'll keep investigating, and we'll keep doing justice there.
But since you've been chief prosecutor of the ICC since 2003, have you opened any investigation outside of Africa?
We have to investigate crime. This is, look, when Rwanda genocide happened...
Let me perhaps just mention, Mr. Moreno Ocampo, let me just mention before you answer this question that by my count, and this is widely documented, there have been seven situations all in Africa. The Democratic Republic of the Congo, Uganda, the Central African Republic, Libya, Darfur, Sudan, Kenya, and now the Ivory Coast. Have there been any other cases?
Because you believe in one of these, you believe there's no crimes in Darfur or in Congo, in Uganda? In all these places, we identify people who commit horrific crimes, killing thousands of people, raping hundreds of women. So I will not ignore these crimes. Rwanda genocide was neglected. The Congo war was ignored in Europe. I will not do that. I will do justice when no one is doing justice. That's my job.
But what do you say to victims of crimes that have been committed elsewhere, Mr. Moreno Ocampo? Are you suggesting that no crimes have been perpetrated outside of Africa?
Look, I have a jurisdiction. I have to investigate crimes when no one else is doing that. So in Spain, Al-Qaeda commit crimes against humanity, but the prosecutor from Spain investigate the case. So if they do it, I cannot do it. So in the past, there were international justice for Yugoslavia, for the Nazis, German people, but now the crimes are committed in Africa, and I will not ignore the African victims.
Would you pursue crimes committed in Iraq, just to give one example, or in any other country recently? Iraq, Afghanistan, would you pursue such cases?
I think it's a neocolonialism try to protect those who commit massive atrocities because they committed in Africa. You can say there are other cases that should be prosecuted. That's correct. But sadly, I have no jurisdiction in Iraq, in Sri Lanka, in Lebanon, in different countries in the world where there are allegations of atrocities. So I cannot do that because I have no jurisdiction there.
All right,
so
I just want to bring us back.
I'm
sorry to interrupt you, but in the little time that we have left, in fact, I can ask you to be brief. Let's bring it back to this case of Laurent Gbagbo. I just want to mention that under the statute of the ICC, a case is referred to the court when a country is seen as either being unwilling or unable to prosecute the case itself. Is this the case with the Ivory Coast? And when we look back at what you've decided to do in Libya, which is allow the justice system there to prosecute Saif al-Islam Gaddafi, when by all accounts the legal infrastructure doesn't exist, how do you compare the two cases? Would you say that the Ivorian justice system is completely bankrupt, that the Libyan is in a much better position?
I'm sure it's very interesting debate what you're proposing, but I have no idea what you say. It's impossible for me to understand, so I'm so sorry for that. So I will invite you to have follow this conversation a different day with a better communication system. Right now, I cannot understand what you are saying. What I insist is International Criminal Court is here to do justice when no one else is doing justice, to do justice for victims who were neglected, to do justice against former head of state who were committing crimes, abusing of power. This will not happen again. We are here to do justice.
Luis Moreno Ocampo, Chief Prosecutor of the ICC, I look forward to another opportunity to speak with you. Thanks very much.